more than enough, Jesus. If all you did for us was to die and rose again, you are more, it's more than enough. If all you did was to die and rose again for us, that is more than enough, because all we could need for life and godliness have been captured in your death and resurrection. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Has anybody received this mercy this morning? Has anybody received his kindness? Has anybody received his faithfulness? Can you lift your hands to heaven and begin to thank him? Begin to thank the Lord, for he is good and his mercy endures forever. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Luke 17:17. That's what the Lord placed in my heart this morning. Just thought to share. Luke 17:17. Jesus answering said, "Were there not 10 cleansed? But where are the 9? They are not found that return to give glory to God, save this stranger." And he said unto him, "Arise, go thy way. Thy faith has made thee whole." You know, one of the things Thanksgiving does is to activate wholeness. This morning, can you begin to give thanks for what the Lord has done for you? Yes, you are expectant. Yes, you have not seen those things that you were expecting. But can you begin to give thanks? Like that stranger, like that one man, we have come this morning to give glory to Jesus. To say thank you for January, for February, for March, now April. Oh, Father, we thank you, for you have kept us. You have sustained us. You have preserved us. The enemy came not but to steal, to kill, and destroy. But you came to give us life. And not just life, but you gave us in abundance. Oh, my God. Father, you are good. You are good. Jesus, you are so good. Jesus, yes, you are so good. What no man can do, you have done for us. What no man can do, you died and rose again for me. Hey, what no man, what my parents cannot do for me. Hey, what no man can do, what no man can do, you have done for us. Jesus, you are so good. Oh, Jesus, you are so good. You are so good. Father, we are grateful. See how far you have brought us. Woo! See how far you have brought us. See how far you have brought us. See how far. Yes, we might not be where you want us to be yet, but we are not where we were yesterday. Thank you, Lord. To you be all the glory. To you be all adoration. In the same vein, can we just give thanks on behalf of Nigeria? I know a lot of things doesn't seem right at the moment. Whether band A or band B, we are band Jesus. And what we do is we give thanks. So can we give thanks on behalf of Nigeria? Because whatever you appreciate, appreciates. So let's appreciate Jesus on behalf of Nigeria. Let's give thanks. Father, we thank you. Father, we thank you. Father, we thank you. For Nigeria, we thank you. For what you are doing, we thank you. For the dollar, we thank you. For our currency, we thank you. For our leadership, we thank you. For divine intervention, we thank you. For supernatural provision, we thank you. For supernatural abundance, we thank you. Thank you, Lord. Woo. You know, Thanksgiving is one of the things that is not so easy to do, especially when you are in the storm or you are in the fire. But we thank the Lord. We move from the place of victory. You know, as band Jesus. I say we are band Jesus. Can you shout hallelujah if you are band Jesus in this house this morning? Band Jesus, can you shout hallelujah? Quickly in the seventh, leading us in the second stanza of the national anthem would be Abiola. To Nigeria, my country, to be faithful, loyal, and honest, to serve Nigeria with all my strength, to defend our unity and uphold our honor and glory. So help me, God. Let Nigeria shout, hallelujah! 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 If you have testimony in the house, we are all testifiers, and the Lord has been so good to you, and you are willing to share. So just go to the back, just go to the ushers and make your intentions known. God bless you.
Hallelujah, somebody. Come on, make that clap bigger unto Jesus. Okay, before we go on, I'll quickly teach us a song. I know most of us, we know it too. When I think about the things that you've done, my imagination has turned to reality. Oh my God, oh, you do this one. You say. Okay, so I think we know it, right? Let's go. Hallelujah. Come on, give Jesus praise. Come on, let me see you give the Lord a dance this morning.
this kind, God, another one, no. Your voices and sing your own worship songs to Jesus this morning. You need to hear your own voice this morning. Come on, just lift your voices in one minute. Sing your own songs of thanksgiving to Him. Just declare to Him that He's worthy to be praised, He's worthy to be adored, He's worthy to be lifted, and He alone deserves our worship, He alone deserves our praise. Come on, let Jesus hear you this morning. Let Jesus hear you this morning. Let Jesus hear you this morning. Come on. With hands lifted, with voices raised. Jesus, I thank you. Jesus, I thank you. Jesus, I thank you. Oh, Lord, I worship you. Lord, I worship you. Yes, sir, you deserve it all. You deserve it all and more. Yes, sir.
Oh, Jesus, yes. Yes, yes. Oh,
For battles won that you never had to fight. If you know what the enemy had planned, you would thank God. Particularly this week, I didn't know what it was, but I knew that God was fighting a battle on my behalf. I didn't care to understand, but I knew that there was something that God was doing on our behalf. So this morning, I just want you to raise your voice. Raise your voice and thank Him for battles that you never had to fight, for victories that you had, that you have, that you never fought for. Give Him praise this morning. Open your mouth and just say, thank you, Jesus. Oh, Father, we say thank you. We thank you. We thank you, oh God. Ah, thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Thank you for fighting our battles. Hey! Ah, we give you praise. Olube Jawa. Alagbara Lamba. Oh, we give you praise. We're going to shout three powerful hallelujahs. You know, especially in this season of Easter, that Christ died and He rose, never to die again. The third day He rose. Three is a number of victory. Is a number of victory. So I'm going to shout hallelujah. Three powerful hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. Amen. Amen. With that confidence, we are going to decree and declare this morning. I'll speak the word. And I want you to say it with all conviction, with all assurance, with all confidence. We'll read together, I want to go. The favor of God is on my life, and everything that I put my hands onto is blessed. The blessings of God is on my life, and it causes me to be fruitful and to multiply. I am the righteousness of God. Therefore, I am entitled to covenant kindness, mercy, and covenant favor. The favor of God is on me and goes before me. Therefore, my life will never be the same. This is the set time for God's favor in my life like never before. Four, never again will I be without the favor of God. It rests richly upon me. It profusely abounds in me. I am a part of the generation that is experiencing God's favor immeasurably, limitlessly, and surpassingly. Therefore, the favor of God on my life this year produces supernatural increase, promotion, restoration, honor, increased assets, greater victories, recognition, prominence, preferential treatment, petitions granted, policies and rules changed in my favor, and battles won in which I do not have to fight. In the name of Jesus, I decree from this moment forward, I see myself the way God sees me. I am highly favored of the Lord. I am crowned with glory and honor. I am the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. The Lord has arisen upon me and shown me mercy. The set time to favor me, the set time is now. I am a candidate of the Lord's mercy. Praise the name of the Lord. If you have enjoyed preferential treatment, praise the name of the Lord. Amen. Smile to someone beside you and say, welcome to church. How are you? You look beautiful. If it's been a while, tell them it's been a while. It's been a while. Amen. You may be seated. God bless you. Is anyone excited to be in church this morning? Okay. Quickly, if this is your first time here in Joshuaville of the Redeemed Christian Church of God, please, can you raise your hands? If today is your first time, oh, all over the room, please, let's rise, and let's give you a Joshuaville welcome. Please rise to your feet. Please welcome them. Get up and welcome them around you all over the room.
Also, we have a huge number in the overflow. We welcome you both here and in the overflow to Joshuaville of the Redeemed Christian Church of God. We are glad that you are here. And during the course of the service, you get to know more about the church. And at the end of the service, we'll give you a proper Joshuaville welcome and hospitality. Let's stretch forth our hands to them and say, Father Lord, for these ones who you have ordered, both here and in the overflow, that as you have ordered their steps here today, that for the rest of their lives, you will continue to order their steps in the name of Jesus. They will not find themselves in places where they do not belong in the name of Jesus. That indeed the hand of God will continue to be upon them and shield and protect them in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, for everything. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. You may be seated. God bless you. We have another set of people we want to celebrate. If we're born in the month of April, please rise to your feet. Wow. If it's your anniversary, you can stand as well. If it's your wedding anniversary this month, you can rise to your feet. Let's celebrate them. Very happy birthday. And we know of a truth that God that has kept you to this moment will continue to keep you for the rest of your life in Jesus' name. This is going to be the best birthday yet. In fact, this birthday, that which you have prayed and longed for, God will grant to you in the name of Jesus. Happy birthday. You may be seated. God bless you. Amen. It's testimony time. Testimony time. Our God is still doing miracles. He's still a God that is what? Doing miracles. Miracles everywhere. Before we go to the testifiers, workers, please, Edgeworth. We might need to move us to the overflow. So any worker in the room, if you're not serving here in the room, please, let's move to the overflow. God bless you as you do so in Jesus' name. Let's celebrate them as they give up their seats for our guests. Thank you. Okay. We have quite a number of testimonies. And so we'll try to make it very fast. Fumilayo Okonta. P-O. So these people will come out. Fumilayo Okonta. Adiola Babatope. Bright Adams. Adeleke Olu. Oluwato Biloba. David Aderumu. And Queen Victoria Anselm. Please get ready to come out. I'll read the remaining. PO, provision, business, and business growth. Period is March. I want to thank God for the salvation of my soul. In January 2024, my sister and I left our job because of the place was... I'll come back to that. Okay, I'm reading Mr. and Mrs. Choloton, Protection and Provision, it happened on the 29th of March, 2024. Praise the Lord, people of God, hallelujah. We want to thank the Almighty God for his divine protection as he saved us from a fire incident. We came for a walk on the 29th of March, 2024, but on leaving the house, we were warming up some food on the gas.
But out of not to be late, we rushed out without putting off the gas, as we forgot. We came then upon getting home. The food we prepared was burning. We could smell it from outside the house. My wife had to touch the door if it was hot. To the glory of God, only the food on the pot was burnt, and there was no fire outbreak, no loss recorded. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. We also want to thank God for his provision for our family. He has been faithful. I pray for his divine protection over us and the church, and that he will continue to be our shepherd and provider in Jesus' name. We'll take Funmilayo Okunta. She's here. Adeola Babatupe, get ready. Funmilayo Okunta, can we double up? Thank you.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I would finish from here. 8 years ago, my mom was diagnosed with cervical cancer just about 3 months after my little brother was born. 2 years later, she went to be with the Lord. I remember those 2 years as the most difficult time in our lives as a family. My mom was often away receiving treatment. She had 9 rounds of chemotherapy combined with radiotherapy. It was a really horrendous experience. She became a shadow of herself, and this, of course, affected the family financially, you know, spiritually. But while I remember the pains of that season and even the pains after, because, of course, you've lost, like, a parent, and it's a very painful experience, I also see how faithful God has been to my family. Things aren't the same, definitely, because my mom is no longer here, but God has really been faithful. Now, the little boy who was just 3 months old when we found out she had cancer, he's going to be 8 this April.
Hallelujah.
Like, in 2 days, he's going to be 8. And so whenever I look at him, he's just a testament of God's faithfulness to the family. And I'm so grateful that God has kept everyone. After that experience, my faith took a hit, because I thought I wasn't upset with God, but I really was. I stopped trusting that he would take care of me, and it affected my prayers. I wouldn't even pray for stuff, because I'm like, what's the point? You didn't listen. You didn't listen when I prayed to you concerning my mom, so what's the point praying to you about any other thing? But in 2019, I remember 2019 December, I was in film school, and everyone had gone home, you know, for the holiday, but I stayed back because I felt like I just needed a kind of quiet time, kind of like a retreat with God. And in that period, he restored me to himself. He comforted me. And there's a scripture that he shared, or that he opened my eyes to see. That was the scripture he used in sort of like giving me peace where with regards to losing my mom. And the scripture he gave me was Philippians 1, verse 23 to 24. And I will just read it, because I don't know if there's anyone here who has lost a parent or who has lost a loved one, and you sort of feel, you still like have the pain, you still feel, why didn't God answer? Maybe you just don't have peace with regards to that. I just wanted to share the scripture. Philippians 1:23 to 24. Please hold on while I get the scripture. Philippians 1, verse 23 to 24. And Paul said, "But I am hard pressed between the two. I have the desire to leave this world and be with Christ, but that is far, for that is far, far better. Yet to remain in my body is more necessary and more essential for your sake." So what God helped me see through the scripture is that, so Paul was saying he's one person, right? And he's saying he could leave this earth or he could go to heaven. So I think what God was showing me is that my mom I haven't lost my mom, really, because she had just left this existential plane, right? She was still existing with the Father in heaven. That is where she is. So I think losing my mom here, yeah, but I haven't lost her. She's still in heaven. So that was like really comforting for me, and I hope that it would really comfort anyone who has lost a loved one. Thank you so much.
Adeola Babatope.
morning, church. I just want to thank God this morning for restoration. October last year, on the 1st precisely, we had a staff summit at the office, and I remember I'd shared the testimony as to how that God had like really helped me, you know, with being the manager of a particular branch I was managing at the time. You know, I got awards and nominations for being the best pharmacist and all of that. However, in the same October, on the last day of October, it seemed like the old story had changed for me. You know, something came up at work, and before I knew what was happening, they said I did what I didn't do. And in the space of one day, like, the whole story changed. I was facing panel, I was being sanctioned. And I remember that for someone that started October, like, on a very high, I that month ended, like, really, you know, not so good for me, because at the end of the panel and everything, I got demoted. They transferred me out of the region, said I should just go and work as a normal pharmacist, removed me from being the branch manager and everything. And a lot of people called me to, you know, sympathize with me, saying, oh, we know you never do this and all of that. And I was just trusting God all through that period that, you know, God was going to sort me out and restore me. And I remember they had transferred me to even a further location than I was in Koyi at the time, moved me to Lekki. And I was just doing my thing, even though I knew I was demoralized at first. You know, it took a lot of listening to a lot of things for me to, like, get myself back and, you know, really do the work that I was meant to do. And all through, like, the 50 days fast, I knew one of the things I was asking God for was restoration. And last month, during the special Holy Ghost service at camp, I was opportune to be present, so I went on Thursday and Friday for Holy Ghost service. And I remember on Friday, there was a particular prayer that G had asked us to pray. He said, God, you know how things are with me. Please intervene. And I really cried to God and, like, said that prayer with all my heart. And starting from when I left camp, because from I left Saturday morning, I had to be at work that morning. So it was like I got home, just took a change of clothes and went back to work. Starting from that day, God actually started the journey of restoration for me. The current regional manager I was working with just called me and said, oh, you needed to discuss something with me and all of that. And next thing was telling me that, oh, he wanted to go back to our MD to talk to her about restoring me to being a manager, to take up in another branch, a new position. And within the space of, in fact, he told me he was going to present it, like, in a few days' time to the at the management meeting and everything. I remember that on the day of management meeting, I had seen him. I was even trying to, like, get his attention to ask, oh, how did the meeting go and everything. At the point, I just left it that, well, whatever will be with me, like, God, I've already trusted that God would do it anyway. And before I knew it, by Wednesday, a mail had already been sent that with immediate effect, that she resumed the next day.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
I just really want to thank God for restoring
thank you,
me.
Jesus.
And I prophesy into the house and to myself that everything that we are believing God for, God would intervene for each and every one of us in Jesus' name. I pray that we will not know shame in Jesus' name. I pray that the only way we'll ever know is the way forward. And I decree and declare that affliction will never arise again in Jesus'
Amen.
Name.
Amen.
Praise
Amen.
The Lord.
Hallelujah. Deola, you've taken up time for two people. Adam's Bright. Please, straight to the point.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Firstly, our light of their life is not growing, but I really want to thank God because I have actually experienced growth Hallelujah. In many different ways that I cannot even start mentioning. And secondly, yeah, so myself and my partner, we started a project about our going to Canada to do our MBA. And it's a lot. It's costing us a lot of financial discipline. We're making the payment in installments every four months. So, and then she has not started working, so I have to be paying rent every month. You know how it is when you're working in Naira and then paying in dollars. So it's a different thing entirely. So, and it was another 4 months again. We needed to also, you know, pay another installment of about $9,000. And then I was looking, a project I had organized in my head that, okay, as soon as we are done with this project, it's supposed to finish then, we're supposed to use the money to pay. But then there were some unnecessary, you know how you have done your Gantt charts, you've done everything, you think, oh, this, we'll finish then. But there were just some unnecessary delay, the project was delayed and payment time was extended, and I'm like, God, I have run out of option. And I was thinking, I'm like, God, this is your project and you started it with us, so you have promised that you are going to make provision. So that morning, it was a Monday morning, I just went back and I was praying and I was asking God, direct my path, tell me what's next to do. So while I was praying, I remembered we have a facility that we rented out to a company. They are supposed to be paying us 8 million naira annually. So they had paid this same company when we were negotiating with them. I had asked them to pay 2 years, but they refused. They say, and I was desperate. I needed money. So I'm like, okay, let's see this thing. Let's pay 1 year. No. So while I was just thinking about it, like, oh God, how am I going to get money? So the Spirit of God just asked me, casually, call these people and make them an offer. Tell them to pay this also amount. So I just casually texted the manager of the facility. I'm like, oh yes, this is that. I need money for this. And then I know your rent is not yet due, but I would want you to make payments today. If you can make payments this particular amount, and then I can afford to give you this particular discount. Usually, because I've had the thought of collecting a loan. But when I did the calculation of the loan calculation, the amount I was going to be paying for that loan would be too much. And then it would be like all the profit I'm making for this particular project, I'm using it to service that loan. So I'm like, I wanted to like have a physical meeting. I said no. So I just casually texted her, like, oh, this is this. So this is the offer I'm giving you if you're willing to do it. These same people that say they are not interested. Before I know, they decided they are going to accept it. Just like
Hallelujah.
That. They accepted it. And Hallelujah. They only decided to pay the money in USD. So Hallelujah. It also helped the value of the money not to drop. So I want to thank God, because nobody else could have done it but God. So, and I pray over the church that the Almighty God, who is a great provider, will continue to provide for us. Make a way where there is no way. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Queen Victoria Anslem.
Praise the Lord, church.
Hallelujah.
Good morning.
Good morning.
So, often I hear people say, I'm here to testify to the glory of God and to the shame of the devil. I don't think I fully understood what that meant. Last month, my friend and I were here, and we did our Thanksgiving. On the 5th, she relocated to Lagos last year to stay with me, so she lives with me. We've known each other for 19 years. On the 5th, on the 4th, I told her I'm not going out because I had like 3 assignments I needed to submit by Friday. So I had no reason to go out. But just when she was about to leave for work, I had the urge to follow her, and I did. And she said, where are you going? You have assignment to do. Those your assignment that you stay till 6 a.m. in the morning. I said, yes, but I feel like going with you. So we left. The workplace is a 15-minute walk, but if you're taking a bus, it's a 5-minute. But most times I drive. But the traffic has been crazy. You can stay 2 to 3 hours in traffic for a 5-minute drive. And I was tired, so I said I was not driving. We left to go and take a bus. While we were trying to cross, a truck took one way. And I'm afraid, like, I'm scared of crossing the road, so she always holds my hand. But that day, she did not. And I was rushing, I was running to hold her hand. And I heard someone called, but actually nobody called. So I turned, and the truck was like 3 feet away from me. So I ran back. When I ran back, a bus that was coming on the right of way hit my side, but the truck had carried her. The truck carried her, and before I could regain myself, people were shouting, she's dead, and I ran to her. When I ran to her, she turned her head, and I shouted, she's alive. But nobody came to my aid. Everybody stood afar off, even while I was crying for help. Called my husband to come out that we were involved in an accident, but he couldn't hear me because I was tired of screaming. Just then, a patrol vehicle went by with army police. They stopped and asked what's wrong, and they saw she or sister. I said yes. And just then, a bus driver that was going on his way emptied his bus, his passengers that were going towards Lakwe. He emptied all of them and assisted me. Now, we drove for the first 1 hour looking for a hospital that would attend to us. Nobody. We got to the first hospital, no doctor there, just two nurses. I was now told that the only hospital that would attend to her was another almost 1 hour, 30 minutes drive. So we started. In that 1 hour, 30 minutes, the army people were clearing the road for us. In the bus, I found myself with a Yoruba guy, an Hausa guy. My friend is an Igbo person. I'm an Akwa Ibomite, and I'm like, this can only be God, Dad. Almost all the tribe in the same bus. I was shouting Jesus. The Hausa guy was praying for me in their language, and he's a Muslim. As we were going, I got tired. I was telling her sorry. She was in so much pain because the truck had hit her. The whole flesh was off. It was just bone we were seeing. But God did something that only Him can do. For that 2 hours that we were driving, she was not bleeding. When a doctor saw me and said, if she was bleeding, she would have died before you got here. When we finally got to the hospital and they took her, I passed out. This hospital only did first aid because I had gone into shock and I passed out. By the time we got up, they had given her first aid and they said they needed to refer her to Ibube. Now we're waiting for ambulance. Ambulance took another 1 hour, 30 minutes. So an accident that happened in the morning by 10 a.m., she did not get proper treatment till 8:30 in the night. But you see, God has a way of receiving all the glory for Himself. While we were going, she was in so much pain, and she said I should give her painkillers. Me, on a normal, I always have painkillers in my bag. But for that day, I did not have, and I said, even if I have, I cannot give it to you because I don't know what it would cost. And I kept telling her, I'm sorry. And I posted, I said, God, you cannot put me to shame. All of a sudden, I started to say the blood of Jesus is the greatest painkiller, and she was calm. And I chanted that all the way till the hospital. Whenever I stop, she would go into so much pain. And this was before I had called Pastor Fon, called Pastor Tyro. Pastor Fon now called back and was praying for her. And he encouraged me that she needs to hear my voice. And I said, at a point, I almost collapsed in the bus, but I just kept holding on. But I realized that each time I said the blood of Jesus is the greatest painkiller, I should be calm. And that was how we got to the hospital. I couldn't stop chanting the blood of Jesus is the greatest painkiller. I never knew the blood of Jesus is the greatest painkiller, but I soon found out. Because she was calm all the way while I was chanting. Whenever I stopped, she would start screaming, start shaking. But when we got there, she got attended to. Now, fast forward to getting to Ibube, she was not accepted. They moved us to Lut. We had to be calling different people. They said, no best space. And finally, a member of the church helped us, and we got a best space. When we finally got a bed space, they attended to her. They said we needed blood, about 8 pints of blood. And the price they were calling was ridiculous. I started to call people in church. And I'm here to say thank you to everybody that helped. Thank you for answering. Thank you for helping to repost. People came to donate blood, and we had more than enough blood. Thank you. She's well. Hallelujah. She's fine.
Hallelujah.
I remember saying, God, thank you, you did it, but there is a but. And He said, what the enemy meant for evil, I turn it around for Hallelujah. Your good. And I kept saying to myself, if I did not go with her, that's how she would have been left on the road, and she would have died. In running from the truck, I ran into a bus. If the bus was on speed, they would say you ran from truck and the bus. In the past month that the event happened, in that road, a car has hit 3 different people and they've died on the spot. And I remember saying, God, car, Abba, hit somebody, they died on the spot. A truck hit her, and she's alive.
Hallelujah.
It can only be.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
It can only be. She does not recall the incident. And when I shared with her, I was scared that she'll go into depression with what has happened. But you see, God has a way of turning things around.
Yes.
She's stronger. She now knows that God has a purpose for her life, because how can she be hit by a truck 10 a.m. in the morning? She did not get help till 8:30 at night, and she's alive. So I'm here to say thank you. Thank you, Pastor Ferry. Thank you, Pastor Juan. There's a lady called Deborah. I'd really like to give you a big hug, Deborah Ojo, because a lot of people that came to donate blood said they saw a post on Deborah's status. I'd really like to say thank you to everybody, those that called, that checked in. Thank you. I pray that in this church, that blood will always be a covering for us. That whatever the enemy has planned for evil, he will turn it around for our good. We will only have testimony to share and never tears.
Amen.
Thank you so much.
Amen. I think God deserves a standing ovation with a clap. He's amazing. God is amazing. You may be seated.
Amen. Amen. We'll call Adeleke Oluwa Tobiloba.
For those of us that are screaming, we'll soon find out.
Praise the Lord, church.
Hallelujah.
I'm here to testify that I'm a candidate of the Lord's mercy.
Amen. Hold on. We know that you have fans. Yes. But please, let's make it very quick.
Yeah. All right. So just last week, I concluded my final exams in medical school.
Hallelujah.
It was so tough because the entire March, I wasn't in church. And like I just had to dedicate time and everything. And then just a few days to my very final. So I'd written the first part the week before the last week. Then the final part is like the determining part, the OSCE part, where everything I've been doing over the years determines at that very week. Then the devil struck. I fell ill a Saturday before that week. I didn't take it serious, and I'm like, whatever it is, I'm going to write these exams. So during the course of my exam, the first day, I was very ill. I didn't want to let my lecturers or anybody around know, because they will feel like, oh, are you malingering? Or is it because you feel like the exam is too hard? And anybody that is in medical school or has gone through medical school, you can understand the extent of the pressure and everything. But I just held it in all through my stations. I was very ill. I just kept confessing the blood. At every rest stations I got, I kept confessing the blood of Jesus and the confessions that we say in church. So the following day, I had another exam because it was every day of the week. And the following day, my body couldn't take it. I was throwing up in the exam hall. It got to a point, my head of department came to meet me and like, young lady, do you want to continue this exam or you want to go out? And going out would mean an automatic receipt. It means I won't graduate with my set. And it's been a whole 9 years journey. Thanks to COVID and HASU, it's been a whole lot. And I'm like, God, you've not brought me this far to now leave me at this very end. So I continued the exams. It was very tough. Like, I've never written anything that hard. And in fact, when I finished, I'm like, God, you know what? I'm not even looking for anything, any grades whatsoever. Just let me pass and go. And to the glory of God, in fact, I was so ill that as soon as I finished the exams, I was rushed to the accident and emergency in Luth because I was terribly, terribly ill. That even the doctors that saw me, they are like, doctor, didn't you just finish exam? Like, why are you here? I'm like, I'm so ill. They saw me, they recorded my temperature. I'm like, how were you able to even write exams with this temperature and the way you are feeling? I'm like, I don't know, but it's just God's mercies. I was admitted for 2 days, two nights, and on the second night, I remembered. I would have thought I was immune to seeing, I mean, what I see in the emergency every day in the hospital. And people around me that were admitted, some people opposite my bed, they passed on and they were wheeling out. And I felt very scared. At that point, nothing medical was in my head. I was just very like, Holy Spirit, please. I kept speaking the blood of Jesus. And the one that stood out to me was, battles won in which you do not have to fight. I did not even remember the entire thing. I just kept saying that part. I'm like, all through the night, I couldn't sleep. My parents are not aware. Okay, I called them that I was sick, but they didn't take it seriously. I just felt like, okay, maybe I was just stressed from exam. But I kept confessing that. The room felt eerie. I was speaking the blood of Jesus. And the blood really fought for me. The blood really, like, they came in the morning. Hallelujah. And I'm like, you're fine, you can be. So fast forward to earlier this last week. My result came out. The very first one, I already gave up and I got just the control. I did not just pass. I'm grateful to God that I passed and I passed excellently well.
Hallelujah.
That alone is my testimony. The second one also, I thought that, okay, whatever it is, they will probably just give me a pass as, oh, we understand that you were ill and you could not perform well. That also came out and I passed excellently well again.
Praise the Lord.
So when Mrs. Chin was saying, Jesus, you do this one. I'm like, God, you really did this one. Not just for me, everyone around me. I remember I was praying for my entire class. And like, God, you know, we've really been through a lot. 9 years is a whole lot. Like, can they just let us go, let us pass? It was very difficult. And result came out and my class, we had 100% pass rate.
Glory to God.
I'm so grateful to God that everyone around me, my friends and colleagues, everyone that we did med school together, today we are standing as medical doctors. I've been looking forward to April Thanksgiving since the beginning of this year. And I'm like, God, I will come back April Thanksgiving and give you the best of my praise. And I'm so grateful that even though the devil struck, I am here to say thank you, Jesus.
Congratulations, doctor. Amen. 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 God bless you. I'll quickly read this one. PO, Provision Business and Business Growth. I want to thank God for the salvation of my soul. In January 2024, my sister and I left our job because the place was, I guess, not so good for my sister. And I didn't have a life outside work. In February, God provided a job with an option match. God provided the job for my sister as well. All we wanted in a job, God gave to us. I restarted my business, and in March, God gave me 2 export orders, which were beyond what I expected. I prayed to the church that all your prayers that you have prayed will be answered in Jesus' name. Daniel Iyola, I'll read. Daniel Iyola. Breakthrough at work. I was really worried for my mid-year performance at work because my projects have been tough. God came through. I was really surprised when my managers on my different projects gave great remarks and rated me above what I was expecting. God bless you in Jesus' name. David Aderomo, please.
Good morning, church.
Good morning.
Can someone please say a big hallelujah to God for me?
Hallelujah!
Today is my birthday. I'm 40 years today to the glory of God.
Wow. Wow.
Testify for the mercy of God in my life. because the devil tried it. I started this week in a hospital bed. And even as of yesterday, I was still in a hospital bed. But I was determined and I prayed to God that I will not spend my birthday in a hospital. And I'll be here to testify for God's goodness in my life. I'm diabetic, and I was hit with what they call diabetic ketoacidosis, which is a silent killer. I never saw it coming, and it hit me so hard that I couldn't stand, I couldn't sit, I could barely lie down. But I thank God for my family, I thank God for the church, for their prayers, and I thank God for God's plans for my life, for not cutting my life short. And, you know, now I know that this is just the beginning. This is, God has fought a battle that I did not even know. And I'll be victorious. He's given me victory. And it put the devil to the absolute shame. I just want to come out here and give God all the glory. Is no one could have done it but him. Nobody could have done it. And I just want to thank him. I want to say, you know, to the church, the greatest wealth that God can give you is health. You know, you can chase after everything, but without that health, nothing matters. So I want to prophesy to the church that affliction will never arise a second time. That God will bless us all with good health and great wealth in Jesus' name to live all our days. Thank you, church. Please shout hallelujah to God.
Hallelujah! And let's shout happy birthday!
Take one more testimony, please.
Praise the Lord. I'm sorry for barging in, but I think it would be very remiss of me not to give this testimony. So sometime in October 2022, we decided I wanted to move up to a bigger house, and we eventually sold in March 2023, moved out in August, and you think, oh, okay. By the time we moved out, mortgage was ready, everything, and you think, oh, it will be a matter of 2 months. Lo and behold, we went back after summer holidays here. September, October, November, December, we're homeless. December, I said, okay, let's take a 3 month lease, and hopefully by that time, everything will be sorted. And he kept saying, oh, just 1 week. 3 months, by middle of March, our landlord said he's coming back, and he needed to use the house. So it was now, where do we stay? Do we have to get another lease? There was nothing happening. And every time we tried to pull out of the deal, they would say, oh, we're almost there. So it was almost like this thing was not working. Anyways, we decided that we have to pray and fast. So we started fasting one day every week and started praying. And I think 3 weeks ago, Travel to Prevail, Pastor talked about, oh, there's something that's really bothering you. By this time next week, it will happen. I was like, okay. I plugged into it. Thursday of that week, we fasted. And then I think I was on my afternoon walk. My wife called me and said, oh, they just called now. They said, oh, exchange is happening. So there's something called the exchange where you sign the contract and then you have completion. Exchange is happening next week on Monday and completion Friday, April 5th. Thank God. Ask me why on Monday that we're supposed to exchange. My lawyer starts saying things like, they have to review the file, they have to be sure that everything is okay. Monday, nothing happened. Tuesday, nothing happened. By Wednesday, we started praying and fasting again. Eventually, on Wednesday evening, they said, okay, send your deposit, exchange has finally happened. Thank God. And then I started praying that, God, for completion, let nothing happen again, no. Thursday before completion, mortgage advisor said, oh, we have to talk to the underwriter about something again. I started sending mails, praying, and then I called my wife, like, let's pray again, no, because me, I don't know. Anyways, to the glory of God, 2 days ago, we got the keys to our house. Hallelujah. The house is finally ready. I finally, by the grace of God, I'm not homeless. My children are not homeless. By the time they come back to school, we have a house. I just want to thank God. And I want to say two things. Fasting and prayer works. I'm not the most spiritual person, they all know. But when push comes to shove, I will fast. And every time you fast, something happens. Another thing, travel to prevail Mondays and Fridays. I don't usually join live. I log in later in the day. But there's always something that you can plug on to. Pastor will tell you, when I wanted to get my residence, when I wanted to get my passport, every time it was always a word from Travel to Prevail. I advise you, there's a platform that you can use. I beg you. It works for me. I'm praying that you should join because you have testimony. So I want to thank God that we're not homeless, and I give all the glory, and I pray that God that did it for us will do it for all of us in Jesus' name.
Amen. So let's just rise to our feet and thank God for these amazing testimonies. Let's give him praise for his wondrous works, because we know indeed these testimonies were God's hands. For the accident that happened and defied everything medically, that God kept her, let's thank him. Let's thank him for the medical doctor in the house who had an amazing result. Yet, through sickness, she wrote the exam. Let's thank God. For the new home, let's thank God. For provision, let's thank God. And I know you yourself have something to thank God about. Open your mouth and celebrate God for his goodness and his kindness towards you. Thank him that indeed he came through for you. He alone could have come through for you. Exalt and magnify his name. Lord, we say thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. We give you all the praise. We give you all the honor. Ah, Father, you alone deserve all our worship. You alone deserve all our praise. And so we give it all to you, all to you today, all to you. You alone deserve it. You alone deserve it. Thank you, Jesus. Ah, Jehovah overdrew. You are always doing things for us. Ah, you are always coming through for us. We are never stranded. We are never put in a tight corner because you always make a way out. Oh, we say thank you. Thank you for the battles won on our behalf. Thank you for the battles won on our behalf. We are grateful. We are grateful. Blessed be your name, O God. In Jesus' name we have prayed. In Jesus' name we have prayed. We'll be taking our offering and our tithes. For those of us who are worshiping with us for the first time, we usually take two offering and tithes now, and then later in the service we'll do our Thanksgiving offering. So I want you to bring a gift to God this morning. And perhaps it could be a seed. Remember, the Bible says in the book of Genesis chapter 8, 20, it said, as long as the earth remains, seed, time, and harvest, it will not cease. So perhaps give a gift or a seed this morning. If you are giving your tithe, raise it to God. If you are giving your tithe, raise it to God. And speak to him about your tithe. That, Lord, as I bring this tithe, you said I should bring the tithe into your storehouse that there may be meat in your house. And I should prove herewith that if you will not open the windows of heaven. So talk to God and ask that God, that indeed the window of heaven will be open, even as I obey and I give my tithe this morning. And for those of us that are giving our offering, we would read from Psalm 126, the Message version. Psalm 126. The Message version. The account details are on the screen. Will be on the screen, but after we read the scripture. One to go. It seemed like a dream, too good to be true. When God returns Zion the exiled, we laughed, we sang, we couldn't believe our good fortune. We were the talk of the nations. God was wonderful to them. God was wonderful to us. We are one happy people. And now, God, do it again. Bring rains to our drought-stricken lives. So those who planted their crops in despair will shout, hooray at the harvest. So those who went off with heavy hearts will come home laughing with armloads of blessing. You can raise your offering up and just talk to God and say, Father, Lord, even as I bring this offering to you. I ask that you will receive it and you will receive me in the name of Jesus, that indeed it will come unto you as a sweet smelling savour in the name of Jesus. We'll be taking our hymn, Standing Up, Stand Up, Stand Up for Jesus. The hymn team.
If you are clapping for God, that's too small. Numbers 10:10. We read together. One, two, go. Also in the day of your gladness and in your solemn days and beginning of your month, you shall blow with a trumpet over your burnt offerings and over the sacrifices of your peace offerings, that they may be to you for a memorial before your Lord. I am the Lord your God. Praise the name of the Lord. Joshuaville, praise the name of the Lord. You may be seated. We'll take the Joshuaville news, after which the Sounds of Heaven and the Psalmist will lead us in a song titled Ijoba by Tim Godfrey. So JNC News Media.
Good morning and welcome to church. My name is Mfona Basi Usoro and this is the Joshuaville News Channel.
I am Joy Igbinedion and you are welcome to the Redeemed Christian Church of God, Joshuaville, where we raise influential leaders fulfilling purpose.
Praise Unlimited Thanksgiving Service for March. Oh my God, with the wonderful testimonies, we were more than ready to sing our praises to God. And leading us on this mission was our very own Minister Kunle Olela, who danced, jumped, and shouted our gratitude to the Lord.
Worship and warfare service was a beautiful time in His presence. Minister Sharon Adaize ushered us into our Maker's presence with songs of adoration as we worshiped the Lord and let Him fight our battles for us.
In celebration of the resurrection of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, Joshuaville had a musical production themed The Chosen One. We were blessed with beautiful renditions of hymns from the hymn team, songs from Sounds of Heaven and the Psalmist, spoken word from Expressions, and not to forget the memorable Bible recitations from the Kingdom Troopers. We felt the love of Jesus in a whole different way. His love is without a doubt steadfast. The best part of the day was the souls that were snatched from the kingdom of darkness. Victory to the resurrected King. The Lord has been wonderful to us at Joshuaville. In March, we celebrated with the Taiwos as they dedicated their handsome baby boy to the Lord.
We also celebrated with the Iyolas who got married on the 28th of March.
We pray that peace, love, and joy will always remain in your homes in Jesus' name.
Amen. To everyone who is worshiping with us for the first time, both online and in person, we are super excited to have you here today. Welcome home. Our services are as follows. Every Sunday, we have two services. The first service begins at 8:30 a.m. and the second service starts at 10:30 a.m. after Sunday school. On the first Sunday of every month, we have our Praise Unlimited Thanksgiving service, just like the one you're attending today. And on the third Sunday of every month, we have our special worship service.
Every Monday and Friday, we have our Travel to Prevail prayers with Pastor Taiwo Bolodeoku at 6:30 a.m.,
on Instagram, Facebook, and YouTube. Join us tomorrow, Monday the 8th, and again on Friday the 12th as we break through in the place of prayer.
Our midweek service holds every Wednesday at 6:30 p.m. on Instagram, YouTube, and Zoom. On the first Wednesday of every month, we have our worship and warfare service where we let God fight our battles for us in an atmosphere of intense worship. On the second Wednesday of the month, we have our special Holy Communion service, also known as At the Table, where we break bread in remembrance of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. So join us this Wednesday, the 10th of April, for our special Holy Communion service. God bless you as you do so. On the third Wednesday of every month, we have our Explore service with Pastor Taiwo Bolodioku and other anointed ministers of God. This is an immersive encounter where we come together as a community to delve into life's experiences through the lens of God's Word. On the fourth Wednesday of every month, we have our confession service, also known as Be It Unto Me, where we declare God's Word over our lives and by faith, we receive the manifestation.
Every third Friday of the month, we have our 12-hour prayer chain from 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. on Zoom. Please join us and be blessed.
On the last Friday of every month, we have our congregational vigil from 11 p.m. to 1 a.m. on Zoom.
And last but most certainly not least, Word Up, which is our type of house fellowship, holds every last Sunday of the month at 6:30 p.m. on Zoom. Please join us for every one of these services.
Have you heard about the Joshuaville membership class?
The membership class is for anyone interested in knowing more about the church and our core values. It's also for anyone interested in joining the workforce.
The classes hold immediately after service on the second and third Sundays of the month.
To register, please use the link shown on the screen.
And you can visit the information desk after service for more information.
Are you in a serious relationship? Are you engaged with the end goal of a blessed and God-filled marriage? Or are you even already planning your wedding?
Do you know that Joshuaville has a marriage and relationship counseling unit where you can be counseled and guided on the godly steps towards your big day and future home? Our counseling is backed up by sessions with the City of David.
If you would also like to have your baby christened or dedicated in church, please visit the member services desk at the end of service. You can also reach out for inquiries via the email address shown on the screen.
Joshuaville's marriage ministry, Faith Mates, whose mission is to nurture and strengthen the bonds of love between couples through prayer, Bible-based teachings, conversations on marriage, counseling, and lots more, invites you to their monthly meeting, which holds every second Sunday of the month after service. The meetings will hold alternatively, virtually, and in person.
If you are married, please make it a date with Faith Mates on Sunday the 14th of April at 6 p.m. on Zoom.
In a world often divided by differences, a powerful force that unites all of us is the heart of service and outreach.
On the 29th of March, Good Friday, members of Joshuaville gathered to participate in We Walk, an evangelism outreach. It was a testament to the power of collective action and the impact of spreading messages of hope and redemption.
Another opportunity to serve awaits us. Our hospital outreach presents a chance for us to extend our hands of compassion and care this Thursday, April 11th, to those who need it the most.
Matthew 25 verse 40 says, "Truly I tell you, whatever you did for one of the least of these brothers and sisters of mine, you did for me."
Each act of kindness, each moment of service is a reflection of our faith and a demonstration of loving others just as Christ loved the church.
We are also encouraged to make our monetary contribution to the account shown on the screen. Also, if you are a medical personnel and would like to volunteer, please see Tosin Olawale or David Ebuk of the Welfare Department after service.
As we prepare, let us remember to pray, give, and participate.
And that's news for the month. For special announcements, inspiration, and more information about our activities here at Joshuaville, follow us on our social media channels shown on the screen.
We look forward to seeing you tomorrow at 6:30 a.m. online for Travel to Prevail.
on Wednesday at 6:30 p.m., still online for our special Holy Communion service.
And again on Sunday for another amazing time in God's presence.
Once again, I'm Mfona Basi Usora.
And I'm Joy Igbinedion.
Remember to stay safe, spread the gospel of Christ, and
have an abundant April.
Praise the Lord, church.
Hallelujah.
Praise the living Jesus.
Hallelujah.
I need us to give God an incredible shout of hallelujah. Praise hallelujah. The Lord.
Hallelujah.
All right, thank you very much. Amen. The song we are doing this morning is titled Ijoba. It means kingdom. For those who don't understand Yoruba. And I pray that as you listen, may God bless you richly in Jesus' name. Amen. Let's go.
Oh,
hands to the Lord this morning and just bless his holy name. Look back and look at the things that the Lord has done. When we see and we hear these testimonies, some of us were in the midst of things that were happening at the time before the victory finally came. And I can tell you, they were scary scenes. As a pastor, you know, you receive calls sometimes. The enemy will try to shake your faith. But yet, he still gives us the victory. We're not mourning, thank you, Father. We're not weeping, thank you, Father. Only you could have done this. Mo dupe, mo dupe, mo. Unto whom you will have compassion. He says, not for he that willeth, it's not for he that runneth, but for God that showeth mercy. Daddy, we are grateful for your mercy over this church. Thank you, because truly the enemy tried, but he failed. Now we have the victory. Give you praise and glory and honor. We won't stop praising you, Lord. We won't stop worshiping you, because you are a good God. Once again, on behalf of this church, please accept our thanksgiving. In the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and in the name of the Holy Spirit. Spirit of God, within the next 10 minutes, speak to us. Let the word of God come with the Holy Ghost sent down from heaven. Let the word come with life. Let the word come with power. Let the word come with revelation. Let the word come with deliverance. Let souls be saved. Let bodies be lifted. Let the captive be set free. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Give a God a big hand of praise. And please take your seats. Hallelujah. I would like to acknowledge, especially, Bible says we should give honor to whom honor is due. We have Pastor and Pastor Mrs. Olayori Yola with us. Daddy and Mommy, you're welcome. CGO Lagos Province 57. You're welcome. God bless you in the name of Jesus Christ. And sometimes it just gladdens my heart to see some people we connect with online, especially from travel to rail. And sometimes when we meet, even abroad in the UK, they say, oh, Pastor, when I visit Nigeria, I will definitely be at your service. I want to acknowledge one of my sisters, Sister Lydia, God bless you and your family. She came in from the UK and said, they will come and join Joshua when they come into the country. We give God praise and glory for what God is doing online out there. And I want to acknowledge those in the overflow. If there's a way you can just show them or probably just put it up there for them. We acknowledge those in the overflow that couldn't have a seat here. Let's clap for them and celebrate them. Glory be to God in the highest. Because the auditorium is too small to take us, so we have to get an overflow. But the Lord is giving us our place. Come on, somebody shout amen. Amen. Thank you, Father. The Lord is turning around things for us. There will be a turning around in your life this month of April, in Jesus' name. Let me share what the Lord want dropped in my heart to with you today. I was pondering and I had this word quickly. And as soon as I get the word, because you know you don't want to quickly forget, you send it out to some of those that manage that aspect of the service. And this is what the sermon will be like. And this is what the Lord is asking me to share about, just in case I forget. You know, you can get busy and just forget. And Lord asked me to talk today to the people about the true worshiper. So sometimes we might listen to exciting messages or messages that we want to, motivational speaking and stuff like that. There is a time for everything. But I don't know why the Lord asked me to speak to people today about the true worshiper. John chapter 4, verse 23 to 24. John chapter 4, verse 23 to 24. But the hour cometh, and now, somebody say now. We normally use this when we talk about night of worship. We give God glory and praise for the night of worship. 2024 night of worship will be coming up. Let's celebrate Jesus later on the year. Now is a time. There's always a now. What it means is that now. Somebody say now. Don't wait for tomorrow. Tomorrow might even be too late, God forbid. Everything you do, you must do it now. The spirit of procrastination, we command it to die now. Everything you plan to do, do it what? Now. Bible says, but our comment and now is when the true worshipers shall worship the Father in spirit and in truth. For the Father seeketh such to worship him. When I looked at the scripture, I said, okay, that's true. When the true worshipers, when the Bible says, when the true worshipers, which means there could be false worshipers within. Are you a true worshiper? Are you a false worshiper? Two things there. If you look at verse 24, it says, God is a spirit, and they that worship him must worship him in spirit. Somebody say in spirit. Louder. In spirit, and you must worship him in truth. My own version can say in sincerity. If you look at other versions, the Amplified version says a time will come. That's the Amplified version. If you have it, you can put it on the screen. I'll just read it here. A time will come when, and I love this, a time will come, however, indeed, it's already here. Somebody's already here. When the true, and in bracket genuine, you know, there's what we call fake products. If you go to the market, you want to buy a product, maybe you're a mechanic or an engineer, you want to buy a proper product, they will tell you this one is this. I don't want to use any number, use any country so I don't get sued or taken to court or anything. But, you know, they will say this one is so-and-so. This one is what? So-and-so. You know what I'm talking about. When the true, the genuine, it's getting to that point, and you're going to be, I pray for somebody under the sound of my voice, you will be among genuine worshipers. It says, when the genuine worshipers will worship the Father in spirit and in truth, reality. There is a worship in reality, not the worship out of fame, worship out of, maybe you want people to see you, the worship out of because everybody's doing it. There's the time that is coming that we're just going to see the genuine, Because watch it, what is happening, and listen to me, Hamilton and Claire, this is a word for someone. The genuine worshippers will be separated from the fake worshippers. The genuine churches will be separated from the fake churches. God is coming for his own. And the Bible says, in truth, in reality, for the Father is seeking. God is thirsty, is seeking just such people as these his worshippers. He's seeking for those that are really looking for him. A lot of people come to church looking for all sort of things. Some come to look for a wife. Come to look for husbands. Some come to look for business contacts. Some come to look for all sorts of things. Everybody has a motive. One person or the other. Who do you come and see today? Some might just come because, oh, they just like the way the pastor wears his tie. You know, I'm guessing that, or maybe the choir sings. There is a time that is coming, and it is now, that God is looking for God seekers, those that are for him. And as I begin to round up, I want us to read the TPT version of John chapter 4. You may not have it, but let me read it here, verse 23 to 24. It says, from now on, worshipping the Father will not be a matter of the right place. Oh, you have the TPG. Is that it? That looks nice. From here on, worshipping the Father will not be a matter of the right place. But what? Louder. It's not about the right place. It's about the right platform, because now they're online. Things are online. It's about the right place. And that's why we've been teaching, and we'll continue with teaching of the will alignment. Because you've got to be in the right place. It says it's not just about the right place, but with the right heart. But God is a spirit, and he longs to have what? Sincere. The days that we're in, there are a lot of people that are not sincere with God. But if you're not sincere with him today, you'll make it right with him. There's too much show out there. Like you say in Yoruba, yeme, yeme, yeme. Too much. Somebody called me to say, pity, we need to pray. Just so much that disgusts God. And when God says something is disgusting, I will show you a scripture. Let's jump to the book of Amos quickly. Then I will give you 5 points and we're done. Let's go to this Amos chapter 5. Let me just drop this one. Amos chapter 5. I was going to bring it through the points, but Lord asked me to bring it now. Amos chapter 5 verse 21. Amos 5, 21. Give me 21. Let's get sincere with God. God is serious. Even as working for God, doing things for God. If I go to do Jesus, let's do Jesus. What are you going to do, Babalawo? Don't be out of it. Let's be serious with this God that we're serving. The days are coming that we have to be. It's now. Don't postpone it. Somebody say, get serious. God says, I despise your feast days. This will not be our portion. It will not be the portion of the church. I despise your feast days. I will not smell. In your solemn assemblies, you know when you say, talk about fragrance. You know the song we sing about fragrance. Because God has a fragrance. The presence of God has a fragrance. Do ye offer me burnt offerings? Not about how much money. And meat offerings, I will not accept them. Neither will I regard the peace offerings of your fat beasts. And the Bible says in verse 23, this is where God is so strong about the heart with us. And we'll talk about it now. Take that away from me, the noise of your songs. You see, you can sing, and I've always told you, sound of heaven, clean heart. Doesn't matter if your voice is singing off key. I know you won't sing off key because we are professionals in this church. We believe in the right thing. If you sing off key, you have to go for training. Well, somebody can come and sing a beautiful voice, but yet the heart is disgusting with God. Look at what it says. Take away from me the noise of your songs, from a heart of sin, a heart of iniquity, a heart of envy. God says, it now becomes noise. To us that are sitting here, if we dance it, to be done. God, like, you know, when you go through a dustbin that is stinking, you say, may the Lord not do that to you. I can't hear your amen. Amen. Take away the noise of your song. I will not hear the melody of thy vows. Let's go to the points. These are very important. Qualifications of a true worshiper. Five things. There are more things because of time. We have baby dedication. We have wedding Thanksgiving. We've got to move very quickly. The five things of the qualification. You're in school now, so you have to have that qualification. Somebody say school of the spirit. Qualification of a true worshiper. You know when they put out adverts and they want to employ an engineer, different, like we're looking for people they want to employ, they will now say, the person must have this so and so qualifications. They begin to write them down. Some of us get scared when we open this paper and say, I don't have this one, no. Master's in clinical, this and that, degree in that, experience 25 years, qualifier. Employers of labor know what I'm talking about. The first qualification as a true worshiper, number one, the right heart. 1 Samuel chapter 16, verse 4. 1 Samuel 16, verse 4. Let's read it down very quickly. Our time is past, man. 1 Samuel chapter 16, verse 4. The Bible says, and Samuel did that which the Lord spake and came to Bethlehem. And the elders of the town trembled at his coming and said, comest thou peaceably? And he said, peaceably I come to sacrifice unto the Lord. Sanctify yourselves and come with me to the sacrifice. And he sanctified Jesse and his sons and called them to the sacrifice. And watch this. The next verse, very quickly. And it came to pass when they were come that he looked on Eliab, one of the people, one of the sons of Jesse that came, and said, surely the Lord's anointed is before him. But in verse 7, he said, but the Lord said unto Samuel, look not unto his countenance. Don't look at his stature. Big boy, tall, sharp, great guy. Look like a bloke. Looks great. He said, don't look at his stature, because I have what? Refused him. And it says, for the Lord seeth not as the man seeth, for man looketh on the outward appearance, but God looketh on the heart. He is the greatest ECG expert. Did you hear what I said? God is the greatest ECG expert. Remember that today. Many of us want to go and do ECG to check whether our hearts are this and that. There's a great ECG. He doesn't need a machine. The minute you walk in like that, he knows that this one is not for me. Shall I show you a scripture? Turn with me to the book of Matthew, chapter 5. Matthew 15, verse 8. Matthew 15, verse 8. The greatest ECG in town is here. It says, these people, they draw near to me with their word. I will praise you from everlasting, everlasting to everlasting. I will praise you from everlasting. And they can sing and shout. Their hearts, look at it. The Bible says, they honor me with their lips. No matter how beautiful the voice is. It says their heart is what? God did not say their heart is not with me. Ote lo, Abuja Noah. Where is your heart when we come to God's presence? Are you expectant? The man of God wants to say, whatever you expect is what you will experience. The woman said, I will touch, if I can just touch the hem of his garment. And she got her miracle. Blind Bartimaeus was blind, but he heard that Jesus was passing by. He was focused. Where is our heart today? The qualification of a true worshiper. Bible says in Proverbs 4:23, guard your heart with all diligence, from out of it are the springs of life. If I read the Message Bible version for you of Matthew 15:18, it will scare you. Message Bible version, Matthew 15:18. These people make a big war. Show. Matthew 15:8. He said, these people make a big show of saying the right thing, but their heart is not in it. Look at it. And I love this version too. They act like they are what? Worshipping me. But they don't mean it. They just use me as a cover. You will not be a user of the Lord. Just use me. Look at that. For teaching sweets that fancy. Things. We talk about things that are fancy. We don't mean it. Get serious with this Jesus. Get serious with God. Enough is enough for playing games. The days that we're in, God is making a separation. He says, I'm coming to look for the true worshipers. This word we have been reading for so many years, you were born again in 1992, it is coming to pass now. The Bible says in the end time, there will be a falling away. It says, men will fall from winds of doctrine. That it just said the wind is blowing. So we will fall away with the wind of doctrine. You are hearing different things. You jump here. Hey, this one is doing happening here, you jump there. Hey, this one is happening here, you jump here. You are tossed to and fro. Can't you just settle down and focus on God? Number two, because of time, a true worshiper worships God in the spirit. Remember the first one? The right heart. The second one worships God in the spirit. Galatians 5:16. Galatians 5:16. We've got to close quickly. Galatians 5:16. The Bible says, this I say, then walk in the spirit. Every time. You know, I talked about it when we talk about the will alignment. The way to walk in the will of God is to walk in the spirit. I'll have the mind of Christ. It says, ye shall not fulfill the lust of the flesh. Fasting and praying is walking in the spirit. Studying the word of God is walking in the spirit. Listen to inspirational songs is walking in the spirit. Not listening to things that will tell you. I talk about palungu and those who think those kind of things that they will just sing. Before you know it, you are confessing what is not. What are you listening to? In your car? On your headphones? At your wedding reception? Dancing in? It did not help us. And the Bible says in verse 17, some of you know you are guilty. But when you see Pastor Me, you tell DJ to put it down. He says, for the flesh lusts against the spirit, and the spirit against the flesh. And these are contrary to one another, so that ye cannot do the things that ye would. Verse 18. And the Bible says, go ahead. You see, these things, worshiping God. He says, but if ye led by the spirit, ye are not under the law. 19. Very quickly, cut off time. Now, the works of the flesh, they are manifest. People come and worship God from the bed of adultery. Come and worship God from the bed of fornication. Come and worship God from the bed of uncleanness, lasciviousness, idolatry. You know, suppose here, when you have adultery, that can never happen now. Me, I'm strong. Then you know, when we talk about adultery, there are a lot of idolatry people in the church. You idolize even the pastor. You idolize that player in the Premiership League. If that player in Premiership League give them time to come to church, to come to his box, wherever he is, they will get there. But to come to church, they won't come. Idolatry. Witchcraft. You say, I don't fly at night. I'm not a witch. But the Bible says, obedience is better than sacrifice. It says the sin of disobedience is like the sin of witchcraft. You disobey God, you are a witch. You cause people to disobey God. You are performing witchcraft. Wrath. Can you put on the TPT version? Do you have it? Just quickly put this verse 20 TPT version. If you have it.
If you see this, he said, chasing after things instead of God, manipulating others. A lot of people, that's what they do. At your workplace, you know what? You do it at your workplace. God will deliver you today. Hatred of those who get in your way. You know what they say get in your way? Those that just want to just make a living. They want to move forward. They want to get promoted. But because you don't want them to be like you, you pull them down. Senseless arguments. You just ask, what happened? I don't even know what happened. Before you know it, the whole place on fire. Because he didn't greet me when I came in. She didn't greet me when I came in. She didn't say thank you. No sort of senseless arguments. And you miss God. God forbid. He says, those who get in senseless argument, resentment, when others are favored. Ah. Remember, but here, we are carrying of God's mercy. So. But if somebody else now becomes that candidate, you say, my own is coming.
Yes.
You understand what I'm saying? You don't get jealous. You don't get envious. Because Bobowa Asikoniyo, look at my fingers. Look at the time, the size of each finger. They're not the same. Everybody has his own time. Your time will come.
Amen.
If you see her, pray over her car well. Bless that car for her well. Don't walk past it as if you didn't see it. The people do it a lot. I say, hello, did you see my... If I next time they walk past, I say, hey, George, have you seen that my Mercedes? Oh, right. Okay, sorry, I didn't see it. Yeah, hey. Call him, come and see. You now walk as if you didn't walk past the car, as if you didn't see the car there. I remember we used to have somewhere like that before. My dad would buy lovely cars like that. She would come to the house and just walk past it. How come we say, nice car? She just walk past it and walk past it. Because she just could not stand it. Let us acknowledge the good things of God. The Bible says, rejoice with those that what? Rejoice. So when they build, afterward they call us many times to go and dedicate houses. Can you imagine me as a pastor going there and saying, They have made me dedicate cars that are bigger than the car I'm using. So you can imagine us. We go and dedicate buildings, projects. Well, pastors are the first to hear the good news. You understand what I'm saying? So what we have, like Paul said, we have learned to make up our bodies. We know how to abase and abow. You see smaller boys that you could give back to doing bigger things than you. You now be saying, You mean not that? No. When others are favored. Temper. Papa, I don't understand some people. You're just temperamental. Kilo day. Why? One small thing. I was just trying to tell you before they wouldn't allow you to talk. What is wrong? Would Jesus do that? Angry, quarrels, only thinking about yourself. Today you will see some thinking about yourself. Being in love with your own. This one is serious. Your own opinion. You are the only right person. You know it all. That is not the cast iron or the qualification of a true worshiper. Number three, because of time, let's run. Glory to Jesus. Give the Lord a big hand of praise one more time. Number three, just two more, we're done. The true worshiper is humble. The true worshiper is humble. We see from our patriarch. Many people say, Daddy, I wonder why is Jesus so humble? That's why God lifted him. Humility. The Bible says in the book of Proverbs 6, verse 16. There are six things that the Lord hates. Now, on everybody's to-do list, on anybody's list of you need to do things or you write things down, the most important thing that you have on that list is the first thing. Look at the first thing that God said. Look at it in the scripture. Next one. A what? Opari. The first thing, you know why? Pride reminds God of Satan. Bible says he was proud. He said, if I can be, I want to be like God. God said, you will not die. Get out of this heaven. So when you are proud, God hates. The fourth one, because of time, the Bible says, okay, let me just quickly read the scripture. James chapter 4, he giveth more grace and resists those that are proud. James 4, 6. We got to close now. Number four. A true worshiper believes in God. Faith. You know why? I will show you the scripture. Hebrews chapter 11, verse 6. You don't come and worship anybody you don't believe in. How? You got to believe in the God. Because if not, you are fake. God says, why you worship me? You don't believe in me. You're just using me as a cover. Hebrews 11, verse 6. But without faith, it's impossible to please God. For he that comes to God must what? Believe that he is. I just love to hit it on that point. Must believe he is. If you really want to come and worship somebody, I'm just giving an example. You want to really adore somebody, just come and do it. The insincerity of these days that we're living now is a problem. People come with fake attitudes, high service, all sorts of things in this world that we're in now. They hate you and they don't like you. What is that? Tell him you don't like him. Okay, what have you done wrong? That's why God himself said, look, if you come to this altar of worship and you have an heart with somebody, you better go and settle it first. He says, unless I'm calling you a false worshiper. I'm not talking to him for the minute. I don't talk to him again. I blocked him. You better begin to unblock before we go to Praise Unlimited. Oh yeah, but when you open your phones now, where you see unblock? Where you see block? Better unblock them now. The one that you have blocked, because God is not going to accept that worship. The worship of which in your heart that you are not talking to her, I'm not talking to him. Jesus was the only one that had the right to say, I will not speak to people again. Stabbed him here with a spear. Instead of giving him a normal crown that had gold, the one that had thorns, they put it on his head. They made him to carry the cross by himself. They whipped him. Did you see those whips, those slashes? They spat at him. The worst part, when you have given him a nice mucose drink to give him energy, they give him bitter vinegar that tasted like those, like taking antibiotic and opening it and swallowing it like that. You know, those capsules, you break it and taste it and see how it will be. Vinegar. But Jesus said, forgive them. But they don't know what they do. God hates unforgiveness. He calls it a cancer. You must believe that he is. You must be sincere. The final one, a true worshiper is dedicated and holy. Romans 12:1. The Bible says in Romans 12:1. I'll put it on the screen for them to see, for the people of God to see. I beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that when you come to worship God, you present yourself, what is a what? Living sacrifice. Holy, acceptable unto God, which is your what? Reasonable service. Another version says, your reasonable worship. Your lifestyle of worship. Look at it. Thank you. I don't know where you got this version from. It says, look at that last part. For this becomes your what? Genuine expression of worship. Our lives are holy. He says, be ye holy, for the Lord your God is holy. I'm not saying anybody is above sin, but you have the revelation to live a holy life. Because sin stinks, SS. It stinks because God says, I won't smell in your assemblies. Whatever it is that is staining you, you let it go from today. You say, I'm not doing it anymore because I won't be accepted. Receive that living sacrifice. I am your worship. Accept this living. I am. I have more than a song, help me. Oh, today I brought myself. I am.
am your sacrifice. Oh, I have more than a song today. I brought myself. I am the fellowship.
Receive
this living. I am. Oh, your worship. Oh, accept.
Let's rise on our feet right now. Lift your hands to Him.
Living sacrifice. I am your worship.
If you look at the end of Galatians chapter 5, it says, they that do these things will not inherit the kingdom of God. They will not inherit the kingdom of God. Yesterday when I was driving, I was just thinking about this heaven. I look about how some people, no matter how big and influential they are. Now, let me just play a small scenario. I remember when my dad was on the sick bed then, in the hospital in the UK, and we were going to go and meet him because we heard about what's going on. We're like, we're going to pray. I remember he told me, he said, please bring me my checkbooks. You know, he said, give me my checkbook. I remember then, and I took the checkbooks. You know, yesterday I was not thinking about something again. I said, look, and of course, he meant to be with the Lord. Doesn't have any access to those checkbooks again. These people that are, it's like once you are gone, you are gone. You don't have any access to anything. People will sit on your head, do all sorts of things. You cannot dare to even argue with them again. Remember, senseless argument that you're having, you won't have them again. How? You can't argue with them. You are gone. Everybody's going to go one day. And we leave everything. It is not whether there's going to be a mansion in heaven or whether there's going to be a boy squatter. Because, or whether they're going to be on the streets of gold or in the everlasting fire. It comes to an end one day. And the things that will not make, because heaven can come calling anytime. Death can come calling. It's where you are standing with God. If adultery is there, death just comes. Look at, people get hit with cars anyhow, with trucks. What if they're not in right standing with God? Everybody has his rapture. Rapture will come, we know. But everybody, what if you go before rapture? Think about it. All heads bowed, all eyes closed. Are you in right standing with God today? All those things that were mentioned on the screen, are they still in your heart one way or the other? Now, I want to ask you a question. Remember, God is the greatest ECG expert. He can see our hearts. And the Bible says, no liar will make it to heaven. So you can't afford to lie, because God forbid you lie. Ananias and Sapphira told a lie. They died on the spot. We don't want to bury anybody in this church. So don't lie. Is your name written in the book of life? If God forbid today your enemy dies, I don't want to say you. Say your enemy. God forbid, you just don't make it till the morning. Will you make it to the streets of gold? Are you sure your name? For those that know that their name, that beyond any doubt, Jesus, I know, I don't have to say, Lord, I'm sorry about this, sorry about that. That you know beyond any doubt. I know he's the ECG expert, you can see. You know beyond any doubt that your name is written in the book of life. Then take your seat. If you are not sure, just remain standing and say, Lord, have mercy upon me. Remain standing. For those, give me a card. Anybody else in the overflow, wherever they are, they should rise on their feet. I want you to say after me, my brother, and anybody in the overflow, anybody watching online, and say, Lord, have mercy upon me. Forgive me for my sins. I acknowledge you died for me at the cross at Calvary. Lord Jesus, save my soul today. Wash me from every iniquity and cleanse me from every sin. Today I become yours, today you become mine. Thank you for saving my soul in Jesus' name. I will pray with you right now. And those in the overflow and those online, anybody making this same prayer. My Father, my God, look upon your sons and daughters. They have come with a sincere heart to surrender their lives to you. Please accept them today. write their name in the book of life. Let it be well with them. They will not be found wanting on that last day. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. And the rest of us, we're going to pray one prayer before I leave this place right now. We're going to say, Lord Jesus, help me to be a true worshiper. Help me to worship you in spirit and in truth. In the name of Jesus, thank you, my Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Hand clap to Jesus one more time. My brother, please, can you step out of your seat? People want to see you. You come back to sit afterwards. Let's clap for those that give their life. We celebrate you. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. All right, we're going to a quick time of Thanksgiving. Our time is past spent. Then we go to the baby dedication and also the wedding Thanksgiving. And we're out of here. By the grace of God, we're targeting 12. I pray we can do it by 12 or shortly after 12. The Lord will help us in the name of Jesus. During the week, I got a revelation again about Thanksgiving. And I was asking, God keeps giving revelations and, you know, sharing things about Thanksgiving. We're about to prepare our Thanksgiving offering. When I look at these testimonies today, yesterday, I had the privilege of going to go and visit somebody who the Lord had just delivered from cancer. When he was sharing his story with me, wow. I don't remember who came and said health. Yes, it was Brother David that came and talked about health. That health is so much, you know, and a week ago, you know how it is when you try and imitate your pastor. There was a video going around. They said, Pastor, Pity said this. So one of the things that they said Pity said was that look upon our kidneys, our liver, our heart, our intestines and everything. God, look upon these kidneys. Look upon this heart. Look upon these intestines. May you not see colon cancer. Because all these organs, they can't afford to fail. Have you thanked God enough for the organs that are working? One, if just one just begins to misbehave, all the money that you are supposed to have given to God for Thanksgiving, hospital can collect it in a second. I think about it. You know, nowadays, hospitals now, may the Lord bless them. Oh, man, sucking to only the Yoruba, pe Olorun ni je ka rogun aisan. Somebody shout amen loud. Ah! That we will not see sickness. My brother David knows what I'm talking about. You will not remember anything like, oh, I have to have this appointment. You just want to get out of there. Come with me with thanks. It's my orientation about this somewhere. And say, I just want to come and thank you. I mean, who are we? Ordinary men. Ordinary men. Some people will just come. Pray, you have blessed me. You have made me what I am. Through you, God has used you. You have ministered to me with the word, with everything. And they bless you with maybe a basket of something or something or whatever, or a gift. Who are we? Ordinary men. They come to say, that's their way of saying thank you. So you are coming with God today to say what? What have you come with your hand? So that's a revelation for you. The account details are on the screen already. Let the Lord minister to you. If you are to pay that bill in the hospital, how much will you pay? Don't let the devil lie to you. This is the moment that we have been waiting for. To say thank you, Jesus. The moment we are going to dance. We are going to dance. This is the moment. This Thanksgiving moment is my own moment. I love the dance. To praise God. Because these legs, what if they were not there? What if the hands were not there? Just think about it. What if that energy was not there? The oxygen you are breathing, what if it was not there? I think about it to be, that's true. Let's thank God. If they say, oh, I don't have a wife, I've been waiting for a job, I like to joy. Whoa, but you can breathe. Eh? Or your kidneys are working. Okay. God has blessed you. You want to give me a seed. It's, you know, sometimes I wonder, it's like an insult to God when you come to him and you give him what you feel, this is just God. Those days when my nan can, we just used to drop little notes like that, dirty notes. They would say, prepare your offering in a proper manner so it will be acceptable. Our parents then will give us offering. They will put it in an envelope. It will be neat. This God. Let's raise up our devices. If you need an envelope to give, probably the ushers will give an envelope. You are giving the cash. That's all I'm going to say. That's all. Thank you for saving the lives of those in this assembly. That's the song of Thanksgiving. Accept our thanksgiving in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Spirit. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Now to lead us in for about 15 minutes, I believe, then we do the thanksgiving and we are done today. This man is anointed and we love him so much. I watched you again on the night of worship 2022. I even posted it and shared that particular clip of the video. Not because you are a part of us here. One thing I always respect is the oil. I don't bring familiarity. You have the oil upon your life. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome once again to this stage, Chubby! Welcome!
Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Can we give the Lord a shout of praise in this house?
Hallelujah!
In which church? Can we give the Lord a shout of praise in this house?
Hallelujah!
You know, it still doesn't feel like Joshua View. Can we give the Lord a shout of praise?
Woo! Yeah.
Maybe just a little more. Can we give the Lord a shout of praise? Thank you so much, PT. Thank you to the pastorate. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. So, I mean, it's the fourth month of the year. Welcome to four people you haven't spoken to today. No, don't talk to your wife. You've spoken to her. Four people you have, and just tell them Happy New Month. God has done you well. That's the word I have for someone. God, okay, why not just make it 10 people, 10 people. Talk to 10 people and say to them, God has done you well. I said 10 people, say, God has done you well. You have to say it like you truly mean it. God has done you well. Come on, come on, everybody, come on.
That's right.
Can I get the look for you? Come on. Why not thank God for it? Do you hear it? Oluwa. That's not what I said. Oluwa. Toby Wonka, Dupe Lowa.
Oluwa. Oluwa.
Oluwa. Oluwa. S-O-H in Dupe Lowa.
Oluwa. Oluwa. Dupe Lowa.
Oluwa. 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 Dupe Lowa.
Oluwa. 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 Dupe Lowa.
We are very much. Some of us cannot go down at 26. minute. Can we have a Holy Ghost party in this place?
Yeah.
Put your hands in the air. Put your
Hallelujah. Let me just, for those that are worshiping with us for the first time or connecting with us online for the first time, we are not always like this. Actually, we are. And so if you've got some life in you, make some noise! Let me tell you why we are. There are many here who shouldn't be here. They are not where they are supposed to be yet, but they are no longer where they used to be. When they look up, when they look back through the course of their lives, where they started from to where they are now, many times they ask themselves, what am I doing here? Many times for people who you saw dancing here, when they assess the course of their lives, they ask God, how did I get here? Some weren't supposed to make service today. From the hospital bed, they showed up this morning. Some, the enemy meant to take them last month. They are still alive and breathing. Some, when the arrows came from one side, God sent it another way. There are battles they are not aware of, but God is winning on their behalf. And so when they praise God with reckless abandon, be careful before you judge them. Joshua View, do you have one more praise in you? Go ahead and shout! Time will fail us. Time will fail us. But this is what God wants us to do. 1 Kings 17:9. I wish we had another half an hour for Toby Walker to walk us deeper into the presence of God. I wish we had more time. But because we don't, I want us to embrace the word of God this morning with joy. The scripture declares and says that with joy we draw from the wells of salvation. This morning, the word of God is coming to you. I want you to receive it with thanksgiving. Let me give you an example. Many have been wondering, how will I survive the season we live in? He told me to tell you, 1 Kings 17:9. By the way, this is not just about material things. God is here to sustain some people health-wise. He said to Elijah, arise. This is the word of God for us in April. He said, get thee to Zarephath, which belongeth to Zidon, and dwell there. Tell somebody, dwell. Here's why. He said, I have commanded the widow to sustain you. How does a widow who needs sustenance sustain somebody else? It doesn't need to make sense to you at the back, but he has commanded them to sustain you. It doesn't matter what the naira is saying, you are sustained. It doesn't matter what band exists, you are sustained. It doesn't matter what the medical report says, you are sustained. Now, when you hear the word of God like this, so how do you receive it? You receive it with joy. So we are wrapping up our thanksgiving because we don't have time. And so this is what we're going to do. We will shout, thank you, Jesus, 3 times and to seal up our sustenance for the month of April. Are you with me? But you will do it with joy. Because however you rise in life will depend on who is lifting you. It is who you live that determines who lifts you. It is your gratitude that determines your altitude. Today, thanksgiving, that word thank you, determines how well sustained we become. Somebody said, whatever you appreciate, appreciates. Heaven is about to make you, the value upon your life is about to go up. Are you ready, Joshua View? You will simply, with joy, 1 Kings 17, say, Father, thank you. We'll say 3 times, and thanksgiving is over. Are you ready? for your sustenance in the month of April. Joshua, what do you say? Thank you, Jesus! For health, for wealth, for life. Joshua, what do you say? For your elevation, your rising, because your background does not have the right to keep your back to the ground, because many of you are going deeper into the presence of your Father in April. What is your response to heaven? Lift up your hands and put your hands together for Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. We give you praise and glory. We are sustained. We are sustained. The word of God is coming to somebody. He said, don't worry. You will not see rain. You will not see wind. You are sustained. Put your hands together as you grab it. Say, God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Let's stretch forth our hands towards Toby Walker and his entire team. Something came upon him this morning. That's not Toby. This is not him. This is a new person. Now let's now decree and declare over him that this new work that has started in his life will increase. Where you are today is the lowest you ever be. Who you are today is the least you will ever be. What you have today is the minimum you ever have. Generations will hear your voice. From Nigeria to the nations of the world, so it is and shall be. Your entire team, the Lord God Almighty, blesses you, replenishes you from Zion. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Let's put our hands together for the Lord. Hallelujah. God bless you. Let's be seated as we now welcome the family of Adeni for their baby dedication this morning. I wish we had the whole day to just go on and just worship and just praise. But we don't. But this is another opportunity to now bless the name of the Lord. Rejoice with those that are rejoicing. God bless you in Jesus' name. All right, let's make it snappy. The family of Adeni, God bless you. Their families, their loved ones. Sounds of heaven, sounds of heaven.
I want to pray and share, oh, and share. Oh, oh Lord.
India, you know what to do by the names. Glory be to God. Jaden, thank you. Obani Jesu, Jesus is King. Olaluwa, God's grace. Oluwa Dolabumi, God's wealth overshadows me. Overflow. Ade Oluwa. Praise the name of Jesus. Oluwa Bukayomi. Glory be to God. God has added to my joy. Additional. Oba Oluwa, God is king. Oluwa Tishe, God has done it. Adeni. We celebrate the Adenis today. Glory be to the name of the Lord. We want to pray and declare and dedicate the song, I believe, of destiny into the hands of the Almighty God. Our Father and our God, we want to thank you for Oluwa Tishe. We give you praise from the moment the son of destiny came out of his mother's womb. We had the voice of the mother and we had the voice of the child. And we are grateful, Lord. Please accept our thanks in Jesus' name. Therefore, we speak over him right now that when it's time for him to walk, he will walk. When it's time for him to speak, he will speak. There will be no delay in the life of this child. The hand of God will mighty upon him. Move from glory to glory and higher heights to higher heights. The peace of God will follow him all the days of his life. Wealth shall be found in his home. Joy shall be found in his home. He will be far from sickness and disease, far from calamity and sorrow. The mighty hand of God will be upon his life for signs and for wonders. We dedicate you today in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and in the name of the Holy Spirit. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Let's give the Lord a big hand of praise. Glory be to God. Wonderful names. It is done. It is done. Glory be to God. Now let's pray for those that came, family members that came. Father, we want to thank you that those that came, oh God, mighty for Oluwa Tishe Adeni. We want to thank you, Father, because they have come to rejoice with them with thanksgiving. Lord, we pray that the sounds of thanksgiving will not depart from their home. We pray that the sound of rejoicing will not depart from their home. We pray, oh Heavenly Father, that they will always have a cause to celebrate and rejoice. Thank you, our Father. Blessed be your holy name. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Amen. Amen. Praise the name of the Lord. Now we have, just don't go too far because we're going to do the enforcement quickly. We have a wedding Thanksgiving. Our brother, the amazing saxophonist. Glory be to God. Diolas, they went to the altar and they went single and they came back married. All right, let's give it to the Lord. That's right. Let's go.
Oh,
Daniel and Anika, be your last. Our Heavenly Father, we want to thank you. Truly, you said it's not good for man to be alone. And therefore, Lord, you created this beautiful bride for your son. They have come back like that last leper. The Bible says that he came back and glorified God with a loud voice to say thank you. Daddy, we are saying thank you for that which you have started in their lives, for the journey that they have begun, for bringing them together perfectly, fit and made for each other. Only you could have done this. We don't take it for granted at all. Either finding the wife, Bible says, finding the good thing, and finding favor with the Lord. Thank you for the favor that has been released over them, even from this moment they were joined together in holy matrimony. We are grateful, Lord. Once again, please accept our thanksgiving, O God, on their behalf, in the name of the Father, Amen. The name of the Son, Amen. And in the name of the Holy Spirit. Amen. And for those that came rejoicing with them, daddy and mommies, and also aunties and uncles and loved ones and well and friends and well-wishers from across around the place, and those watching us online, our Father and our God, we pray that you will bless each and every one of them. Amen. And those that are trusting for this same miracle, let things turn around for them. Amen. Let them be next on the line. Amen. In the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. And finally, the sound of rejoicing and the sound of celebration will never depart from their homes. Amen. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we are praying. Somebody shout hallelujah. All right, that is a moment, and those of you, please take your seat for a few minutes, 5 minutes. Daniel and Abike and the Adenis, where are you? You run off. Okay, come forward. You know what to do because of time. So we have to be very quick. I'm sure you all come prepared. Mics, technical department, can we have microphones as soon as possible, quickly? We have to close the service. We're supposed to have closed at 12 for the Thanksgiving service. Okay, you know what to do. Who is first? Many more. You go.
All right.
They are prepared. Can we have some quiet minute, please? Shh. This is the moment you're waiting for, so please keep quiet.
I can't contain my joy.
Wow.
Okay, firstly, my guy. We finally get to attend Faith Meet. No more access denied. Ah, thank you, Jesus. It's hard fitting all my love into notes, but here goes. Olakemi, October 31st, 2020, when I saw you after 7 years since we last had contact, I was excited to see you, but then I didn't even know why. But now I know. That's my deep connected to your deep. It's been 3 years, 5 months, and a week now. And I am still super excited to see you. And I know it's not just happiness, this is joy, because the Holy Spirit is bubbling inside of my soul. My sweet cheeks. I'm deeply in love with you. Thank you for replying to my Facebook message and texting me on WhatsApp. Thank you for all the beautiful moments, from the Twitter bands to Spotify nights to game nights and even our dates, both physical and virtual. My rainy babe, I call you that because I know you are very smart. Lord has blessed me with a wise woman. My Miss Smarty Pants. My sunny sun sunflower. I call you that because it brightens my world. I mean, it's evident. My love springs. Because when I see you, love springs from the inside of me. My brown skin, baby. Thank God you can no longer hide your skincare routine.
You have to round up.
My home, I would always love, respect, cherish, and support you. I'm your number one fan.
What's the song? You know it now. I mean, you need your sax. Let him get his saxophone. Media, get your cameras ready for the moment. Where's the mic?
I wish I spoke. Okay, but I'll be quick because of time.
Yes.
My darling Daniel, I'm so glad that I didn't get to kiss frogs before I kissed Prince Charming. And I'm grateful to God that growing up, I hear it's good to wait. And trust me, it's actually good to wait.
Glory to God.
When you say, I love you, I don't doubt it because every of your action shows it. I got a poem. I will quickly say that. They say sometimes love starts with a spark. And that might be true. But if I were to wish us a love, I wouldn't wish fire for us. You see, fire is powerful. It burns bright, then it's gone. It's beautiful and warm, but it doesn't last long. So instead of wishing us a love that burns, I wish us love like a river that twists and turns. It changes and flows. It is powerful and free. But it consistently finds its way back to the sea. And so, like the water, I hope our love is ever growing, ever changing.
Right.
I hope our love is powerful and free. And may we always find each other like the river finds the sea.
It's time to sing a song in 1 minute, or less, in a few seconds, all right?
Okay. My love, there's only you in my life, the only thing that's bright. My first love, you're every breath that I take, you're every step I make.
Let's hear
from the Adenis. All right, Mr. and Ms. Adeni, over to you, please. Hey, can we have some quiet, please? Shh. Hey, we won't leave here in time, all right? People of God, we've got to close. Let's hear from the Adenis. Okay. I love the blue.
Ayomi.
Wow.
My happy place. My peace of mind.
Wow.
My guy.
Uh-huh.
My bestie.
Glory.
My number one cheerleader. I choose you every day and every time. I didn't know what marrying your best friend means until I met you. You are my first thought every morning and my last thought before I sleep.
Wow, wow.
You inspired the love in me that I never knew was possible. You are the most courageous and selfless person I know. Thank you for being an amazing husband and father to our son, Obani Jesu. Thank you for being a priest over our home.
Glory to God.
Thank you for always being on standby and ready to help. Thank you for the constant reassurance of love. I love you till eternity.
Can you please give us a song? Don't worry about the musicians. They are musicians, but just sing "The Lord Hears Your Worship."
Okay. I need you the most. Ife mi, Oluwa lo fi esa emi.
Himself. Then we are done.
I think the bar has been raised already, but I'll just try. For me,
look at her in the eyes and do the needful.
Allow me, my love, my sugar baby.
Glory.
My one and only Mimi, my dearest. I just want to thank God for the gift of having you in my life. For being such an amazing woman, for being a beautiful and handsome wife, for being a loving mother. Thank you for your love. Thank you for the sacrifices. Thank you for taking care of me and Oba. Thank you for giving up of yourself, your time, your body, your spirit, your career for the period of 9 months to welcome our baby. Thank you for all you do for us. Thank you for even the moments that you could not sleep, you know, rolling up and down the bed just because of the inconvenience you faced during childbearing. Just want to thank you and appreciate you this day. And I just want to borrow a word from a movie I watched just to describe who you are and how beautiful you are to me. And it is the word pulchritude. It's gotten from the Latin word poke, and it means beautiful. Beautiful in and out. Isn't it, church?
Yes!
I just want to say this day that I love you, my dearest.
Glory to God.
And I will not trade you for anything. And I want to say this day that I love you. I'll keep loving you. And I pray for grace to keep loving you and to be committed to doing life with you now to eternity.
Now you know what to do. Just sing. Few seconds.
Media, you help me.
You want media to help you, Abby? What song do you want to sing? Our time is past, Ben.
Okay.
We will start counting.
The second stanza of the song Perfect.
Praise God. Help him.
I found a woman stronger than anyone I know. She shares our dreams. I hope that someday I'll share our hope.
Ends around 11:30 to 12. We've gone past our time now. Just one more thing. Now today is very special because we are going to call Mr. and Mrs. David Aderimo. I would want to pray with you. It's your 40th birthday. We must pray. And please. And we're going to call out Ayodeji. It's your birthday today. Our amazing trumpeter. Please come up. David, please, sorry, we have to let you come up. I know you're trying to gain your strength back. Please, you have to come with him. Huh? You must come together, hold your hands together, and we proclaim a blessing over your life. 40 is very significant. I never knew that you were going to 40 today. Even though we have organized a big party for you. We'll pray for you first, we'll pray for your day, G. My Father and our God, I ask for the ministers to please stand. Let's prophesy and speak into his life. 40 is not anything that is ordinary. People have gone before 40. We know many people that have gone too soon before 40. God has kept him alive. And 40 signifies a new season. Jesus fasted 40 days and 40 nights. Moses took the mountain 40 days and 40 nights. The ark was on that water for 40 nights and 40 days as well. We prophesy a new season over your life, dear Adin Rumus. Over your lives, we prophesy the new season. Let it begin to manifest in your lives, in the lives of your children. In the name of Jesus, you will move from glory to glory. Higher heights to higher heights. We bless you in the name of the Father. We bless you in the name of the Son. And we bless you in the name of the Holy Spirit. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Happy 40th birthday. God bless you. Let's celebrate them. Ayodeji. Ayodeji and wife. It's his birthday. We don't play with birthdays. The Bible says, teach us the number of days that we may apply our hearts of wisdom. So let's put our hands towards them, all ministers. Let's pray for them. We pray that in the name of Jesus, because they are one, they will both live long. Amen. To see their children's children. Amen. On to the third and the fourth generation. That days will never be cut off from the face of this earth. They will celebrate many, many more birthdays in divine health. They will celebrate anniversaries in divine health. The Almighty God will bless the work of their hands. We take them from glory to glory and higher heights to higher heights. Thank you, our Father. We bless your name, O God Almighty, forevermore. Thank you for one more year again. You've added to your Son and you're going to add so many more years unto him. We give you all the glory and praise. Please accept our thanksgiving in the name of Jesus. And we bless them in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Spirit.
In Jesus' name we pray. Happy birthday, Adesha. God bless you. God bless you, my sister. Thank you. Let's celebrate the Lord. The final thing. We have Temitope Badmus and Chinwadek. They are getting married on the 13th of April. So come and present yourselves. On the left. It's our custom in the Redeemed Church of God and also in Joshuaville here to present to you those that are going to the altar. That's why we take it like this, so that at least you know those that are going to the altar. That of course we have consented to this wedding. This woman and this woman alone. This man and this man alone. So we are presenting them to you now. Alright? Father, we thank you for this couple to be. We pray that in the name of Jesus, on that set day, you will bless them like never before. The weather will favor them. Even the economy will favor them. Their marriage will be blessed. Their union will be blessed. Their home will be blessed. Their lives will be blessed. Their career will be blessed. Father, that which they need, you know the things in their hearts that they are crying to you in the secret about, as the Spirit of God is telling me. Father, answer them by fire. Let their prayers be answered by fire. Let it be well with them. That day will be day of rejoicing. No one will come across accidents. Their loved ones and those that well wishers that we come to and fro will arrive safely and go back home safely. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, Lord God Almighty. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Congratulations, Evans, Tim Tokwe, and Tinade. God bless you. All right, it's time for us to shut down the service. And before we do that, I also want to mention that if you notice, we had some people that came and danced around. The doctors that graduated from Luth, we celebrate you because of time. Wherever you are now, we're going to just pray with you because of time. We know you are somewhere in the congregation, and we lift up a prayer for those that graduated. We heard from all the testimonies as well. Father, bless them. Bless their career. Take them from glory to glory. All these ones that have graduated, Father, they will never fall short of your glory. They will never fall short of your power. This is the beginning of miracles in their lives. You open doors for them. Great doors of opportunity have opened for them. In the name of Jesus Christ, we have prayed. Let's celebrate those for the doctors from Luth. Well, bless God. All right, you are here for the very first time. Before I call first time, I just want to announce again, please note, our services, we have two services here. Because of the size of the environment, we had to take another hall again and put other people in the overflow. Our services are two services every Sunday, 8:30 a.m. in the morning, and ends exactly at 10 a.m. The next service is the second service, 10:30 a.m. in the morning, and ends exactly at about 12. Today, we had one service, and there's so many things we did together. That's why we extended to past 12. We don't even normally extend like this, but today, our Thanksgiving service could extend, depending on number of baby dedications and stuff we have. So pardon us with that, and the Lord will help us in the name of Jesus. Wednesdays, we meet either for a worship and warfare service or the at-the-table service, communion service, or what we call our interactive service, which is our explore service, or the beat unto me service. They're all always online, pending the time we will move into our final site. Please note that. So we will be having them online, 6:30 p.m. in the evening. And join me for Travel to Reveal. You've had the great testimonies coming from there. 6:30 a.m. in the morning, Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube as well. All the four platforms were there, 6:30 a.m. to about 7 a.m. or 7:15 thereabout. There's also and a very important announcement about the hospital ministry, Pastor Bio. Do you want to quickly come and talk about that? I will stand with you so you'll be very quick. Do you have a mic with you? Just any mic from the sound of heaven. They always have mics with them. So please, let me just...
Hallelujah. Thank you so much, sir. Good afternoon, church. So on Thursday, by the special grace of God, we shall be visiting the clinic. So if you are interested, you can see me after the service, not to take too much of your time. And if you are interested in also supporting us, I'm sure that after the service, the banner will be somewhere on the screen. So please reach out. The Lord bless you in Jesus' name.
Thank you so much, Pastor Bayo. The hospital ministry, we're pushing on that, and Pastor Bayo is driving that. And let's do put all our support in for that. The account details we put on the screen, probably as we are closing this service. So every first Sunday of the month is our Thanksgiving service. That's where you are now. And the next Sundays are always two services. Don't forget that. Next week, Sunday, we'll continue with the series, The Wheel Alignment, The Wheel of our Alignment. So let's bring our friends and loved ones for two services, 8:30 a.m. and the next service, 10:30 a.m. in the morning here at the M1E Life Center. The Lord bless you as you take time to join that. If you're not giving your offerings or you're not giving your Thanksgiving offering, you can ask the usher for the account details. Very important. Don't leave here without your offering. Give your offering, your tithe, or your Thanksgiving offering. We did very, 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 very important. For those joining for the very first time, can you rise on your feet very quickly? This is your first time here. You've never been here before in Joshuaville. Just rise on your feet. We just want to acknowledge you one more time and say thank you. Thank you for coming all around the place. All around the place. And those in the overflow as well, we want to acknowledge you as well. Those in the overflow, we want to acknowledge you as well. God bless you. Thank you so much for coming. Now, please, we crave your indulgence. We want you to pack all your belongings, our first timers. We have a very short reception for you. So you're not coming back to your seat. Please pack your belongings. Step out. Let's clap for them as they do that right now. Just for about 5 minutes, you meet with the Joshuaville Hospitality Department. Glory be to God. All right. One more thing very quickly again is that if this is your second time, you came for the very first time last week and you came again now for the second time. I'm not calling you out, just wave your hand to me. That your second time. Wow. One, two. Anybody else again, just wave your hand to me. Thank you very much. God bless you. We would like to see you after the service. Just for 2 minutes, come to the front. We have a gift we want to give to you. And the Lord will bless you in Jesus. The rest of us, let's rise on our feet. It's been such a powerful time today. Give the Lord a big hand of praise right now, wherever you are. Somebody shout hallelujah! So much excitement in the air. God will do great things this month of April. Like Pastor Paul has said, sustainers are certain. God will sustain you. Believe his word. Believe his prophet. The word of God will come to pass in your life. In the name of Jesus. Let's declare our 2024 confession. For the Lord has arisen upon me and has shown me mercy. For the set time to favor me, yes, the set time is now. I'm a candidate of the Lord's mercy. In Jesus' name, amen. Let's declare the blood covering. Very important. You had the testimony of Queen when she said, when this dear sister was bleeding. In fact, there was one thing she missed out of that testimony, because of the state fright and everything. She said that as soon as she was spilling the blood, you know, she kept on feeling better, and even the blood, whatever was having at the time, stopped. And even one of the medical people within the ambulance at that time was like, lady, can you just continue doing what you are doing? Because what you are doing is actually working. What was she doing? Bleeding the blood. So please don't take it for granted at all. This is a very important confession. It works. The blood works. One to go. And the blood shall be for us as a token upon the house where we are. And when you see the blood, you will pass over. And the plague will not be upon us to destroy us when you smite the land of Egypt. Heavenly Father, in the name that is above every other name, look upon each and every one of us, spirit, soul, and body. As we step out of this place, Heavenly Father, the vehicles that convey us, some that will travel, fly in aircraft, fly or wherever they go, the very roads that we cross, some that we cross the roads to the other side, some that might go on ferry or go on the sea or wherever we are, look upon our health again, our kidneys, our livers, our heart, all the organs on the inside of our bodies. Look upon our going and coming out and everyone connected to us one way or the other. By the reason of the covenant, look upon us as we step out of here and please see only the blood. And so shall it be in Jesus' mighty name. And may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit rest and abide with us now and forevermore. Amen. Surely his goodness and mercy will follow us all the days of our lives. And we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. God bless you. Thank you so much for joining us, our online viewers as well, those on YouTube and on Instagram. It's been a very long service. We appreciate you. We look forward to seeing you again and again and again and again. God bless you. Thank you so much. Thank you so much.